depends on the intensity of your devotion. Let's go through this. Number one, it depends on what you want from life. So what will your life be about? What are the components of your life? Is it going to be only work, or work and family, or work and family and friends, or work and family and friends and hobbies, or work and family and friends and hobbies and also make a contribution in society, or even multiple works and interests? So what is the level of complexity of the mosaic of your life? If you make a pie chart of your life, how many, you know, pieces will it have? Because that will determine the amount of energy that you have to distribute. It will also determine your level of attention and resources you will dedicate to each of these dimensions of your life. I'll give you more detail. You can't be 100% in all of these. If you have 10 dimensions in your life, maybe 10 is too much, but it will give you an idea. Let's take it to an extreme. If you're interested in arts and sports and family, you know, and you have a greater family, and you have you're committed to your friends and spending time with them, and you have interest in the environment, and you know you like animals and history, and you're into the cinemas, you know, and at the same time you like politics, and you have multiple businesses. Let's say you're invested in you're running multiple companies, or you get the point, and you like sports. You can't be 100% in all of these. It's impossible. You can do them, but maybe at like 30-40% each. If the number of your interest is less, is smaller, you can do them at a higher. You can do them at 60%, let's say. If it's even smaller, you can do them at 80%. I'll give you another extreme example. Let's say you only have two main interests in your life, your work and your family. That's relatively easy. You can easily afford to give, you know, 90% by 90%, or 80% by 80%. When I say 90 by 90, I don't mean it in a way that they should all come to 100. I'm not talking like this. I'm saying, you know, you are 90% satisfied. That's what I'm saying. You're like 90% ideal family man. You're 90% ideal professional or businessman. That's what I mean. However, listen carefully. If you want to be 120% in something, 150% in something, then you have to forget about many other stuff. You can't be 150% in one dimension of your life, let's say work, and at the same time be 80% or 90% satisfied with your contribution, or, you know, ideal in the dimension of being a family person, and, you know, socially active with your friends, and taking care of your hobbies and other interests. It doesn't work. People who are super achievers, who are 100%, 200, 150% in what they do, you know, the big names that you hear in the news, big achievers, people, the billionaires, remarkable artist, you know, remarkable scientist, Nobel Prize winners or laureates, amazing artists and athletes. These people, if you look at their life, they're almost mono-dimensional. Maybe one or two small other interests. To be a successful athlete, this is like, I don't know, 15, 16 hours, maybe, I don't know, maybe it's too much. 10 hours of practice every single day. Discipline, dedication. Dedication and discipline. Whatever the job is, to be a scientist, you know, you have to spend hours and days where your friends are partying, or they're on vacation, or they're enjoying their hobbies. You will be in the lab or in your office studying and reading and researching and experimenting. To run, to be a billionaire and run, you know, multi-billion dollar company, this cannot happen with a 9-to-5 job. You can't have these desires and wants at the same time. It will frustrate you. Because it's simple, my friend. It's really simple. Go to physics. Input and output. The relationship between them. You want to be exceptional 150% in your work, you have to put the proper input, and you don't have unlimited resources. So you have to make up your mind on where you allocate resources. So can you have sort of balance? You can have balance based depending on what you want, right? If what you want practically is feasible in creating balance, then fine, you can do that. But if what you want is unrealistic, right, in terms of balance, then you're asking for the impossible, because it's all about energy and attention and time that you have to spend to get what you want. So decide what you want and know what matters most. I can't overemphasize this point. Know what matters most to you. Go to your heart, ask yourself this a million times until you have the same answer and you're comfortable with this answer. You have peace with this answer because it's a reflection of who you are. And once you have this question answered and you have peace with that, then go for it. If all what you want is research and science and being number one at, you know, world-class level, then go for it, but know the consequences. And if what you want, no, I'm going to be okay. I don't want to be exceptional. I want to be okay because being okay with so many other things fulfills my life. So if you're in peace with that, go for it. But first, understand what you want. And second, understand that you have finite energy. Manage that properly. And then maybe you live with more peace with yourself, no less frustrations, and you will get what you want. And that's what's important, at least. And it's something to get what you want in life.